Hello everyone, in this video I will show you how does an edge bridge works and how to design it. So first, here are two op amps and these will set the dead time because that's necessary to not short out the main power supply. And these will feed those signals into these drivers, and here this was tricky because it needs a floating ground that I made in this way: a capacitor, a Zener diode and a resistor, and this is not the best way, so maybe I will make it in another way. And this is needed because you can't just connect this to this ground, because between this line and this line there is 50 volts. So it would be very hard for this Zener diode to dissipate that much power. And of course the same case here, and you don't really need these Zeners, these are just paranoia. And here I only need to amplify the discharging current, because these optocouplers can charge it up nicely through this diode. And of course all diodes should be ultra fast, because slow diodes just can't handle 200 kHz. And if your MOSFETs or IGBTs don't have internal built-in diodes, use an external one. Those will help to protect the transistors against the high overshoots. And here this capacitor is needed even in DC circuit, because with this, these transistors can supply a higher current into this base, so it can switch faster. Because with a slower switching speed, it has high losses. And this is not the best solution, because my transistors are only rated for 800 milliamps, but I hope they can handle it for 3 nanoseconds, because I calculated that after that time it will fall under that, the current. And I used a simple online calculator, you can find it really easily. And these resistors shouldn't be wire wound ones, because those have a very high internal inductance which will increase the overshoots and decrease the speed, which is not good. And these potentiometers should be in any value, because these are just simple voltage dividers. And with these you can set the dead time, which is of course necessary, I set it. And of course I will do some scope measurements if I will put together this circuit. This is just a schematic which I hope will work. And these optocouplers are necessary here, because this floating ground, which I told you why is it so important. And these need 50 milliamps to turn on, and with that value you can easily calculate that you need here a 214 ohm resistor, or a bit higher maybe. And the input square wave signal will look like this. And with a simple LC circuit. I will make these slopes, so on this you can set the dead time, as you can see here, of course with those op-amps, and it will look something like this instead, because of the capacitor, like this. And here is the final signal that you will have on the primary, and it may have some ringing in the dead time or overshoots, but don't worry about that. If it's under 100 volt, these transistors can handle it. And the waveform on the floating ground capacitor will look something like this. So it will charge up through the 75 ohm resistor, and then when it turns on the gate of the transistor, the voltage will drop, and then it will slowly go back, and of course slowly, because it will supply a constant current to keep the voltage down, instead because the Miller capacitances can pull it up, which is not good, because it can short out the main power supply. And here in the dead time it can charge faster, and here again it will drop, and this will repeat. And of course always use ceramic capacitors in these circuits, because they have a lower internal resistance and inductance, so they can react faster. And later I will talk about these snubber networks, because I can't just tell it now, because I have to experiment with them. And I will, as you can see, I will run it from a 50 volt power supply, or even higher. Or I could use mains voltage, but that would be dangerous, and my MOSFETs can only handle 100 volts. And it's better to not use like 90 or 100 volts, because you have to have some headroom, so your MOSFETs won't die like on the first try. And I hope this